It may only be an hour outside of Manhattan, but the quiet town of Cranberry, New Jersey feels like it's thousands of miles away. In this historic village is a little French bistro called Hannah and Mason's. Friends Chris and Brian were co-workers here under the previous owners and jumped at the opportunity to buy the restaurant 3 years ago.
Can we get serious now, please?
All right, come on, focus, focus.
I was afraid from the beginning to take the restaurant.
Oh, what the fuck am I doing? This.
I was also a little short of cash, so I figured Brian knew the operation. We worked together already, and he had the other half of the cash.
We could do this. We could do this.
But looking back, no, I don't think I would go into business with Brian. This was a mistake.
I'm very laid back, and I don't think I let a lot of things bother me.
Brian, you suck.
Whatever.
Brian's very lazy.
Brian can be lazy.
Brian needs to step up a lot.
I just find it difficult to be motivated. That's just how I've always been, and I find it difficult to change.
When your heart's not in it, why doesn't anybody else be in it? Why?
I agree.
My partnership with Brian is not equal.
Enough. Enough of this shit, please.
I generally pay most of the bills. I spend a good portion of the day ordering food, doing prep lists, working on menus. Generally, I'll work the line for most dinners.
Brian, why are you clean?
Hold on. I don't particularly like to work the nights, so we're only open 3 nights a week for dinner.
Done. There's no more to be had.
I really don't think we're losing out on any business.
There's nobody here. People call and they ask, you know, can I come in on Tuesday? And no, we're not open, and you can't bring in the customers, you can't bring in the money.
We're having a very tough time making ends meet. It has been increasingly more and more stressful to come in and look at how much we owe money to, and the bills are piling up, and it's a little too much stress for me.
All right, this pretty much sucks. Hopefully we make some money tonight.
I go to try to deposit my paycheck in the bank, and I can't because there's no money.
I get sick of how much money we spend on bounced check fees. It's a horrible feeling.
Oh, my gosh.
If Hannah Mason's ever had to close, I would be lost because I wouldn't be able to support my daughter.
You know, for me, it's a career. I don't know anything else. I don't want to really know anything else. I'm trying to hold out for hope. If it goes on much longer, I don't know what I'm going to do.
What a beautiful, quaint little town. I can't think of a better way to spend Valentine's Day at Hannah and Mason. I guess I couldn't afford the end. That's not a good start. Right, here we go.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Good. Follow me. Okay?
Excellent, that's fine. Lovely. And so you are?
Nick.
Nick. Okay,
yes,
okay,
sir.
Great.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise, good to see you too. And what do you do here, Nick?
I'm the manager here.
Manager. Mm-hmm. But you look young.
I am very young, yes.
I'm only 23 years old, and I bust my ass in day in and day out.
Chris.
Yes.
He's sitting down. He's very cute. When I saw him walk through the door, and I says, oh my gosh, look at this man.
This is Marie. She's going to take
Hello,
care of
you. Nice
Hi.
To meet you.
Gordon.
Marie.
Happy Valentine, my darling.
Happy Valentine to you.
Excellent.
Is this a picture of your wife?
Yeah, that's my dear lady, yes.
Can I see?
Oh, please, yeah. That's the 14th Valentine's Day. We haven't been together.
She's beautiful.
Thank you, my darling. Can't wait to taste the food.
I would suggest just to start off with the baked onion soup.
Right. Are you asking me or telling me?
If you want my suggestion, baked onion soup.
Let's go for that, shall we?
Okay.
The quiche, yes. A little slice of quiche.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm fascinated by the lamb lollipops.
Okay.
Lovely.
Got that.
Lovely. Thank you, my darling.
You're welcome.
Well, the start point is onion soup, that's for sure.
We're going to start with onion soup.
Okay.
Some people might say, oh, French onion soup is French onion soup is French onion soup. But I think ours have a distinct, you know, presentation.
Wow. Let's start off with 0 out of 10 for presentation.
Lovely.
Ooh, greasy. Kate with cheese. Kate with bread.
The only thing missing is the soup.
What is that in there? Absolutely tasteless. It tastes like I've just had the dregs from the dishwasher. Hardly any soup. That is shocking. That was very different.
Did you like it?
Once you got rid of all the bread and the cheese and the gunk, it just
okay.
Very, very bland. But I'll bypass and hopefully the lamb lollipop. We'll be tasting.
Want those next?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Fine dining. A fine mess.
And he didn't like this.
Off to a great start, ladies and gentlemen.
Once he got past all the gunk with the bread, he said the broth was just bland, and he's never experienced anything like that before.
He's never experienced anything as amazing as that.
We've gotten, you know, fairly good reviews here, so I find it hard to believe that it's really as bad as he says.
Say something, Chris. Get mad, Chris. I want Chris to get pissed.
This is not going to go good, because if I can't get him with the French onion, nothing's going to be good.
Wow. That is a big, big lollipop.
My goodness me. It's an absolute nightmare to cut, undercooked. It's hideous.
Chris, no matter what anybody says, I still think you have the best onion soup and the best lamb. If he talks shit about the lamb, he's out of his mind. It's completely ridiculous.
That sauce there,
that's hideous.
It's like a caramel, it's sweet as anything.
Larry, what did you say that was?
A roasted garlic jam?
God.
Nick, would you have a little taste there? It's like someone's put a topping of a granulated sugar caramel.
Although Gordon didn't like the lamb, all the employees and all the customers think that that's our best dish.
Very sweet, the sugar.
Sadly, the lamb is raw and it's obviously cold in the middle because it hasn't rested. Okay, let's go for the quiche. Darling, you've got to turn away now. I don't want to see you facing that shit any longer. Absolutely appalling.
You said he ordered a rare, not raw. And the sauce is a spoonful of sugar. So, Chris, why did that go out like that?
Where's my car keys?
You gotta go out there next time he says something.
I will. You're starting to sound like my wife now.
You're cowering.
Whatever, I don't know.
Chris is definitely scared of somebody telling him his dishes aren't good enough. It frustrates me as a manager because he needs to put his foot down sometimes.
Here, possibly, my darling, they're gonna be saving the best for last. Lovely. And what flavor quiche is it?
It is mushroom and spinach.
Mushroom and spinach. Yes. Lovely. Thank you, my darling.
You're welcome.
Damn. My quiche has collapsed. It's gone into, like, this sort of meltdown. It's almost like it's been left out of the refrigeration all day. And as for the salad, well, you do get really nervous when the ends of the salads are all black.
I have a feeling I'm getting yelled at already.
They sort of collapsed and went all sort of runny and soggy.
I'm sorry.
Huh? Happy Valentine, my darling. Thank you.
Oh, good.
No, he cut into it and it just collapsed and it's all gooey inside.
The customers mostly have good things to say, so it's a little shocking to hear someone say that almost everything that we served them was horrible.
Bye, darling.
This quaint village had put Gordon in a pleasant state of mind.
Chris' name is
Chris.
Chris, and where's the brigade?
Unfortunately, the food destroyed it.
This is my partner, Brian.
Brian?
I'm not really nervous to meet Chef Ramsay. You know, we thought everything was gross, but whatever.
Okay, lunch was hideous. It's really important, before we go anywhere, I need to know the foundation. How many nights a week are you cooking?
Well, we're only open 3 nights. A week for dinner.
Only open 3 nights a week, why?
Being ridiculously cautious and fearful and the way I've led my entire life.
You've played safe.
Yes, sir.
But sending those kind of messages out to the local community that you're closed longer than you're open is telling the locals you're closed. If he wasn't here, what's his weak points?
He doesn't have a love or a passion for the business itself.
So how come you're passionate and you're not?
We're just different people. Yeah, business is a business. Yeah, it's a restaurant. Yes, I love to cook, but it would be easier sometimes just not to own a restaurant.
When was the last time you made a decision?
Right, I made a special.
What was it?
Turkey panini.
Turkey panini.
Right. I'm just, you know, I don't know what you're looking for.
Passion, strong will, determination. You look like you're just about to lose your virginity.
Sorry.
Something needs to happen to relight this flame. Now, I'm gonna see how you operate it, okay? I'll see you in 2 minutes.
Right now, I am absolutely unfocused for dinner. I'm gonna be thinking everything I send out is shit.
Unbelievable.
All right, let's just get focused and let's get ready for dinner, because dinner's gonna be a debacle.
Gordon was shocked to find out that Hannah and Mason's is closed more than it's open. But this is Valentine's Day, a day when all restaurants are busy.
This is our special Valentine's Day menu.
And a great opportunity for him to observe a dinner service.
Okay.
So we have two tables upstairs, right? How many people do we have coming in the immediate future?
I knew that going into Valentine's Day and knowing that Chef Ramsay was going to be overseeing everything that was happening, I was definitely a bit nervous.
Dear, dear.
Is that ready to go out, that?
No, sir. Display purposes only.
Seriously? What the fuck is that?
It's apple cobbler.
When was that made?
Well, it's anyone's guess, Chef. I mean, not more than a week ago. And
holy shit.
That's a molten lava cake.
A molten lava cake? Yeah. No, a molten rock. Yeah. Lava rock.
Well,
what'd you do with that?
Well,
do you play ice hockey?
No, that's, again, display purposes only.
Right off the bat, we were in the shits right off the bat.
Why would we even think about going to a customer with something a week old?
Oh, we shouldn't.
Thank you. Brian.
Yes. No, that doesn't look good at all. I agree.
Yeah. It's disgusting. Yeah? Hello? Get rid of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
As tensions mount in the kitchen, customers are about to celebrate one of the most romantic nights of the year.
Happy Valentine's Day. Thank you.
So food sat up there. Nobody taking it.
I didn't hit the bell.
What? Come on, guys, huh?
Whew. At least you don't work for a long time.
I could never. No way. No fucking way. I think after the first day, I would just leave and never come back. I wouldn't care if I didn't get paid. Chef Ramsay telling me that, you know, we do things the wrong way, just doesn't really work for me.
Oh, my God. Ryan.
Yes.
2 seconds.
And he, like, never shuts up.
Who's checking this stuff? Does this guy just send food out?
Yeah.
So who's checking it?
Nobody's checking.
Nobody, no. Okay. There's lettuce all fucking rotten there. Yeah? Lettuce rotten there. Yeah.
Fisk, you gotta pick through the lettuce better.
I really am trying to. Like, I'm not
These ones are no good with the rotten lettuce. Let's just go.
Oh, fuck me. Where's this coming from?
Jesus Christ almighty.
Has it been washed?
I did not wash it.
No.
I did not know.
We don't wash spinach?
We get it pre-washed.
You get it pre-washed? That's a first. Look, every time I dig my hand in, it's all rotten. You
toss it. Yeah, it's gross.
Well, I wouldn't toss it. Why don't you eat it?
No, I'd rather not. I wouldn't eat it.
But you charge people for it. Okay, there you go.
This shouldn't be sent out.
No. You should open your fucking eyes.
We'll try to fix whatever issues we have, but I'm not gonna cry in the corner about it. You know, life goes on, so.
Upon further investigation.
Oh my God.
Gordon discovers that something is missing from the display only dessert tray.
Have we served that dessert on there?
Yeah.
Here we are.
That dessert's been served from there.
That's not good.
What's this here? It's been leaking in the fridge.
That's really old. It's a bread pudding. That's
a bread pudding?
Sure.
That's a shrimp.
Fuck it.
The smell.
Yeah, that's disgusting.
Why is it bubbling?
Because it's old. That's gross. We'll get rid of all of this.
No. Nick, I know you're busy. Yeah, I'm fucking shitting myself now.
I feel when, you know, things aren't going good, I just as soon get out, you know, just move on to the next thing.
Hey, where's Brian? I know you want to run away from it.
I'm not running away.
No, I can't run away from it. Yeah, I've just been watching and fucking shitting myself for the last hour. What are you doing to people? Give me an answer!
You know, we can't oversee everything. We assume that, you
okay,
know.
Take me down to the fridge. I want to see how you fucking really work. I cannot believe that this is how you guys are running a restaurant.
In my head, I was thinking,
we're gonna be screwed.
That's what in there?
That's the walk-in freezer.
It's the freezer.
That's the walk-in freezer. Look at the mess here. What's this here?
Bacon.
Yeah, obviously, bacon, smart ass. That's from lunch.
Yeah.
Yeah, 5 years ago. You leave a spatula in there like that, I'm sorry. Nah, fuck off. I cannot believe
what you guys are doing here.
There's so much going on. My head was spinning. My head was going to explode. I thought to myself, this is a disaster.
What's that in there?
Shit, that didn't get put on.
Oh, my God.
I don't know what the fuck
that's all. Oh, fuck off. Oh, my God. Oh, no.
This is not good.
Raw chicken.
That should never happen.
Oh, my God. Chris, it's fucking chicken against raw chicken.
It's fucking...
Hey, panini head, are you listening to me?
Yes.
You're going to kill someone. I'm eating here. Partners. Partners in crime. You should be ashamed.
We are ashamed.
You've just contaminated the town. And Nick, stop. Yeah, everybody. Right now, this is not a romantic eat out. This is a Valentine fucking massacre. It's a disgrace. How can you do this? I'm closing the place down. Switch it off.
It's Valentine's Day, the busiest night of the year for restaurants. But what the customers don't realize is that some shocking discoveries left Gordon with no other choice but to shut it down.
Switch it off!
What do you want me to tell the people? I'll tell them.
You tell me then. What are we going to tell them? Or you think I'm going to stand here and watch you serve contaminated food?
No.
Yeah. Yeah, fucking shut it down, switch it off, and condemn it.
I knew that we were going to run into some problems tonight. I didn't know it was going to be this bad.
Mark, turn everything off. That's it. We're done.
No one touches or serves any food. Right, all the way down. I suggest you start coming up with some suggestions to the customers, yeah?
Yes,
yeah?
Sir.
Yeah? Hurry up, Brian.
Chef Ramsay is shutting us down.
I feel absolutely horrible, and
certainly not something I expected.
Just for the evening. Never in my wildest dreams thinking that we would have to shut down.
This is the most horrific thing I've ever had to deal with in my life, quite frankly. I felt horrible.
What I've just discovered is totally unacceptable. Enough's enough.
Chris.
Yes, sir.
If you are passionate about food,
yes,
and
sir,
you feel deeply about it, I want to hear it.
I'm ready. I'm ready to tear it down and start over.
You've got a big pair of balls facing those customers tonight. What they can say for the partner that you are in business with. Where were you? How many tables did you talk to? How many customers did you apologize to?
No.
How much support did you give the waitresses, the manager?
Damn.
That's right. You were doing jack shit, mate.
I do feel like I carry the bulk of the restaurant. Oh, it absolutely bothers me that Brian doesn't take on some of those things.
You make me sick.
Unbelievable.
On a night when they should have been busy serving, the staff finds itself cleaning up the mess.
I don't even know where to start.
I mean, I never really thought I'd be in this situation. I'm really trying to see the light at the end of the tunnel. I'm trying to hold out for hope.
Oh, my God. Of course I'm worried. This is my life. I need those customers to come back.
Before Gordon unveils his plan for change, he explores the town of Cranberry looking for inspiration.
This whole town is built up on farms. Perfect position to have a local restaurant. Wow.
Amazed by the number of local farms in the area, Gordon decides to check out the seasonal produce.
Hello, ladies. Huh? So
welcome
happy
to Turrihan Orchards. Delicious. We're glad to have you.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
Absolutely
thank you.
Amazing. Just
well,
driving around locally and just looking at some of the farms. I mean, it's a chef's dream.
We pick everything every day.
Amazing. And in terms of variety of apples, how many do you have here?
We grow 35 different kind of apples.
Pretty good crunch there.
Mmm, delicious. Right, should I just help myself?
Yes, your favorite.
Fill it in.
Excellent. Lovely. Look at the size of these. Great. That is amazing. Yeah, I'm going to put these to good use. Excellent.
What are you going to make?
Oh, that's a secret. You're going to have to come for dinner.
All right, we're available.
Thank you.
Inspired by the fresh, locally grown apples, Chef Ramsay heads back to the restaurant to work on a special he has in mind for tonight's dinner service.
Right. What are they called?
Apples.
Fucking smarts.
You asked me what they were. They're apples.
Yeah, no, but it's the way you say it. You're with no enthusiasm.
If I want to learn to cook like you, I'll definitely buy your cookbook. But this, it's just not for me.
why are you in business running a restaurant when you're completely passionless about talking about ingredients?
It's a fucking apple. Yes, they're local apples. That's great.
Okay, when was the last time you tasted one?
It's been a while. I haven't been to the local orchard to get an apple.
Taru Farm, well, I've been there for the last 2 hours.
Okay.
It's like being around your parents when they're arguing, and it's the most uncomfortable thing in the world. And now I hated it.
Yeah, it's a good apple.
You don't get it, do you?
I do get it.
They're delicious. And so talking to you about it, it's like, oh, really? It's an apple.
Yeah.
One a day keeps the doctor away.
Am I supposed to jump up and down?
No, not at all. It's just becoming clearly evident that you are incredibly soulless when it comes to food.
You're entitled to your opinion.
If Chef Gordon keeps pushing me, I just won't be here anymore. You won't see me today.
As Brian cools off...
Okay, apples in.
Gordon teaches Chris a new special.
Everything has to be relaxed.
Pork medallions with caramelized Braeburn apples.
And then just finish with a hint of the mustard. Yeah?
Yeah.
Hoping to put the Valentine's Day massacre behind them, the staff gears up for dinner service and takes advantage of the local produce.
Apples are good.
Are we ready to go, yes? Yeah? Okay, guys, let's go. Let's get them in.
I have no qualms about leaving. I feel bad for you guys, but there's no way. If you start sitting with that shit again, I will fucking leave.
Let the bloodbath begin. I'm gonna do the best to get Brian more focused for dinner.
Brian, why don't you show me your passion and lead the brigade tonight?
Sure.
It's fine.
That's fine. That sounded enthusiastic, didn't it?
I don't feel like I need to prove anything to him. I mean, I am who I am, and what are you gonna do?
Special, we have sauteed pork medallions.
I will have the filet mignon.
Harvest salad.
You fire the entrees on table 5.
What's first up, Brian?
What's that?
What's first up? What's going
on? I'm running around trying to get all this stuff together.
With 5 tickets on the board, is it worth getting something going? Brian, it's a very quiet kitchen.
Normally it's quiet. We don't tend to yell, shout out, or...
So how do you guys know what's going on when no one's talking to each other? We haven't said anything.
I guess I'm not running it then.
Nothing makes me angry and not getting served in a restaurant.
Beginning of service, Brian told me he's going to run the kitchen and run it with some passion, but so far I don't see it, I don't feel it, and the kitchen is backed up. Customers are complaining about waiting, and I don't think Brian actually gives a fuck.
I'm just waiting for my
entree. Which one? 102 still? Okay, I'll get it. 102, how long? 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4?
Not really sure.
How long have you been waiting?
15 minutes.
15 minutes.
Fucking shit, dude, this is taking forever.
Brian, yeah. Should tell Nick to slow down the orders or what?
He should know. I mean, we shouldn't have to tell him. He could tell that we're backed up.
So. Oh, my God. Come on.
Brian is not putting in enough effort.
It makes me frustrated. He needs to step up more.
I feel pressured when someone's there watching me and telling me I can't do it, but I don't need him here yelling at me. That's not going to make me want to work any harder.
Your lack of excitement and passion bugs me. I'm struggling to come to terms to why you're in business.
I'm not like you. I can't get excited over
it. It's not what you're doing to me. You've got to understand that. It's what you're doing to the business. The business for me is the bigger picture. I'm not here to massage your ego. I'm really sorry. Customers are complaining about waiting. Doesn't that mean anything to you?
I just felt like I was being picked on and whatever.
Panini Head, I'm worried about how much you're putting the business down. But
you
won't accept that, because you can't be honest with yourself.
Because I'm not. Oh, you're being a dick about it.
What am I being a dick about? Talk to me.
Just the way you talk
to people. Don't run down the stairs like a little girl. Talk to me.
I'm talking to you. You don't talk to people. That's your problem. Calling people a panini head.
No, I called you.
That's like fucking sixth grade. How fucking old are you? I don't need someone to tell me, you know, talk to me like that. I'm past that point in my life. It's just ridiculous. Enough is enough. I'll leave it. Fuck, man.
It's an hour into dinner service, and Brian has threatened to leave the restaurant.
I'll leave it.
With no food leaving the kitchen.
Fuck, man.
Everything is at a standstill.
I don't think he's gonna walk out tonight.
Yes, you will.
I don't.
He's on the verge right now. He gives us another hour. He says if Ramsay keeps taking it, then he's leaving.
Brian did get a little frustrated with Chef Ramsay.
And I don't know what's going through Brian's head right now.
If I didn't give a shit, you know it, I would have left a long time ago. I'm dedicated to this place because I want to be here. I want to do this. I want to make it work.
All I want is just for you to show a little bit of interest.
I am
stop moping around.
If I wasn't interested, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be doing this.
front.
In my heart, I do care. Maybe I don't show it all the time, and I should, but I definitely need to show that I have more interest than what I'm perceived to have.
Great, let's go.
This is table 11.
Table 11.
I gotta wrap a couple more pork.
Table 102, an FO.
Okay, here we are.
I'm sorry about the wait. I apologize.
Hit the bell, please.
Wow. Keep going, yes?
That is going. Table 3.
Table 3.
Table 3. All right, thank you so much. You were braver in that whole That really goes well together.
Thank you. We started pumping things out. It took a little bit while in the beginning, but once we got going, it went over pretty well.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Good news tonight is that the special sold out.
Yes.
Yeah? Great news. Brian, you're smiling for the first time since I met you.
I'm changing right now. I mean, I need to be able to have a positive attitude all the time.
Let me tell you something really seriously, honestly. If you actually think this restaurant in this community is going to be here in 5 years' time when you're mediocre, bang.
We know that, you know, we have to do something different to make the business grow.
Thank you. You're absolutely spot on. We have to be special, and we have to cook locally.
I think the products we had today were excellent, so it would be good to, you know, put a lot of that into our menu.
That's what we have to change.
Yes.
Tomorrow, we're gonna revamp the whole fucking place.
I think we need a change, but I'm nervous, scared.
Tomorrow morning, this place becomes the crown jewel within Cranberry.
I really don't know what to expect.
Is that clear?
Sounds good.
Is there anyone here that's not fired up? Okay.
Let's do it.
With Brian finally on board, Chef Ramsay moves forward, transforming Hannah and Mason's from a dreary bistro into a delightful cafe.
Right, good morning.
Good morning.
Excited?
Extremely excited.
I've got you an in.
Oh, I didn't fail. Oh, shit. That was awesome.
Happy with the end?
Yes.
Yay. Now it's time to open a new chapter for Hannah and Mason's. Let's go.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow. My God.
It's absolutely amazing.
The floor. Oh my God, I just couldn't believe how great it looked when we walked in.
A new deli counter showcasing local fresh products.
Oh my God!
We didn't just renovate this place, we changed the meaning of it. The breads, the homemade cupcakes, everything made locally.
I like it.
Local farms share the pride and you show it off. This place can become synonymous with these farms. You know, it's got synergy there.
Oh my God.
It's amazing.
It's the happiest I've ever seen you. If this doesn't relight your fire, I don't know what will.
I'm glad Chef Ramsay came and, you know, he made these changes. It's amazing. It really is. And I'm hoping that, you know, it makes our business all the better.
Beautiful.
I think I'm in shock. The restaurant is gone. I just don't know.
You don't know? Oh, no. You changed your mind?
I don't know. It's a complete... Hannah Mason's closed last night. Hannah Mason's Bakery and Cafe opened today. I just don't know going forward. I mean, everyone's afraid of the unknown. I knew there was going to be changes, but this is a complete departure from what we've done.
Hannah Mason's didn't close last night. We've just changed.
We changed completely.
A new
completely.
Chapter.
It's overwhelming.
Just embrace change.
Just being a realist.
You're not being a realist. Yet. You're being pessimistic.
Chef Ramsay obliterated Hannah and Mason's as it was, and it's not gonna work.
Gordon has revealed that the new Hannah and Mason's will be an upscale cafe and no longer a French bistro. But not everyone is comfortable with the change.
Embrace change!
Just being a realist.
You're not being a realist, yes. You're being pessimistic.
Right.
Okay, we'll go through the menu. Previously, the menus, two menus before, lunch and dinner. Absolutely crazy. You've got no idea how simple this is. Fine dining has gone. Yes, it's small, but it's powerful. Fresh, vibrant, rustic, countrified cuisine. Brian.
I'm ready to get started, see what all this stuff looks like.
Chris. Look at that face.
I'm just reading the menu. Thinking in my head, it's different. It's definitely different.
Why did you ask me here?
This is because we needed a kick in the ass. It's just things going through my head. That's all. Let's see.
Chris is really nervous to make the change, just for the fear of losing business that we have.
Yesterday, he astounded me. Today, you're shocking me.
Because I'm shocked.
Oh my God.
I need to get my hands in it.
While Gordon had the staff focusing on the new menu, his team put together a farmer's market, an event to showcase the new relationship between Hannah and Masons and the local farm community.
We gather here today to celebrate the relaunching of Hannah and Mason.
Thank you, sir. Let's go. Hi, guys.
Good morning, Chef.
Good morning. How are you?
Right.
Fantastic.
Awesome.
So we've got some taste of olives, we've got some scones, get the staff involved, and make sure all these menus go off as well, yes?
Okay. Hello, everybody. A little chilly out today. Scone?
Right, flyers giving out, a little taste. Let's go.
So this is our new menu.
We're reaching out to the community. It's gonna flourish our business to a whole new level, you know? You gotta see it, it's beautiful on there.
The new menu looks really good.
It's
great.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Day for you.
Yes, it is. Thank you. It's great for me to meet the local farmers.
I love the idea of using locally.
Yeah, I hope you enjoyed our apples.
We did. They were awesome.
Well, let's see if we can work something out so
absolutely.
You can use more local produce
we
all year round.
We absolutely can. Yep, we are going to absolutely do that.
Great.
I hope that people are going to be happy that we're using low growers. And people are always happy about that. And you taste it. You definitely taste the difference. There's no doubt about that.
After a successful farmer's market, Gordon introduces the new menu, a menu created to take full advantage of all that the local farms have to offer.
Let's go through the menu, yes? First of all, just look at the color of it. It oozes what?
Vibrancy.
Freshness. The dishes you can recognize easily. The ribeye sandwich, smoked chicken salad, beef hash with eggs. The entrees, a really nice winter free-range chicken stew. The lamb burger, great short ribs. Fish of the day is gonna be the swordfish, yeah?
I like a lot of the items, and I like the menu, and I like the simplicity of it, but I think there's going to be a learning curve.
Any questions?
No.
Excellent.
Did you see the sign? It's Hannah and Mason, not Hannah and Meso.
All right, come on in.
We're right here.
We have a couple changes to our menu, as you can see.
The chef's special today is a grilled swordfish served with tarragon mashed potatoes.
This morning, I thought Brian would be really anti any form of change, but he's actually embraced it quite well. But Chris, he's been on and off the train all day long, and the jury's out as far as I'm concerned on him. But tonight we'll find out who really wants to turn this place around. It's been an interesting launch.
Gordon knows that in order for Hannah and Masons to make a profit, they must successfully flip tables and have two complete seatings.
Chris.
Yes, Chef.
We have to flip tables tonight.
Well, what does that mean?
Making money. I know you're not used to it, hey, but we've got to do it.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
I don't feel like I'm in control at all for what's going to happen this evening.
Not until the tickets start rolling in. It's just the anticipation at this point.
I think the special sounds really good, though, too. The swordfish.
Here she comes. First order. Well done, yeah. Brian, one cop salad away, please.
Okay.
And four is up.
Gently, gently. Good. Nice. 2 and 20 gone, Brian. Yes?
Yes, Chef. First course on 23 just went.
This tastes homemade. Much fresher.
Tastes so fresh.
Salad, soups moving out.
Yes. Quickly, yes.
Yeah. Any complaints? Any feedback?
No complaint about the freshness yet.
No complaints about the freshness.
No complaints about the freshness.
That was a joke.
Yes, it was. Yes,
good.
Sir.
I've never seen him move so quick. You all right? Yeah, let me just check. Yeah, I'm a thermometer out again.
I'm alive. I got a pulse.
Yeah, no, just it's moving.
Yeah.
Huh? Surely there must be a difference inside here.
With Brian rising to the occasion and getting appetizers out promptly.
Sorry?
Go start turning those tables there now.
Yes.
It is now up to Chris to deliver the entrees so that the next round of customers can be seated shortly.
Next table?
Right now, nothing else fired.
Nothing else fired. No. Give me Nick, please. Anything about to be fired? Anything happening or? Gotta turn. Chris.
He's killing me. I said you're killing me.
Nick, are we falling behind or?
Yes, I think we are falling behind.
unbelievable. Last night, the appetizers took 20 minutes to come out. Tonight, they're only taking 12, but that's not the problem. The problem is the entrees aren't coming out quick enough, the customers are staying at the tables longer, and we need to flip those tables if we've got any chance of surviving.
Get some tables up.
Yeah, with a queue at the door now, we've got to push these tables out. Go on, what are you waiting for, Marie?
Table four,
yeah. Open up, buddy. What's going next? Come on. You got backing up with tickets. You've got to talk to these two guys. Someone needs direction here a little bit.
I'm going on a salmon and crab and a swordfish, so I need mashed potatoes, please.
V86 mash, unless we got some somewhere else.
Having run out of mashed potatoes, Chris makes a very telling decision.
Not going to be serving mashed potatoes on the swordfish anymore. We were running low on mashed potatoes. And I didn't think it would be a big deal to sub something out. I'm thinking in my head, I don't want this to get backed up, then the whole house of cards falls.
Can't we put potatoes on, Chris?
I mean, by the time we get them peeled, we're gonna put them on. Might be tomorrow.
Oh, here we go. It's just excuse after excuse after excuse. You own the fucking place.
Yeah, you damn straight.
So you want to tell the fucking customers we can't be bothered to make a fucking mashed potato?
We can sub something out.
I just find it embarrassing.
Why can't we sub something out?
You said take it out.
And we could sub something out.
Just too easy. Ah, fuck it. Do the easy route. Yeah, tell the fuck off. We can't be bothered anymore.
You're the boss, chef.
That's bullshit.
It's the heart of dinner service. And in an effort to keep up with the orders...
Go start turning those tables there now.
Yes.
Huh? Hi.
Chris decides to cut corners.
Not going to be serving mashed potatoes on the swordfish anymore.
Oh, here we go.
We were running low on mashed potatoes. And I didn't think it would be a big deal to sub something out. I'm thinking in my head, I don't want this to get backed up, then the whole house of cards falls.
Just too easy. Ah, fuck it. Do the easy route. Yeah, tell them to fuck off. We can't be bothered anymore.
You're the boss, chef.
That's bullshit. All you need to do is peel half of the potatoes. We get them on.
Celia, peel some potatoes, please.
I've tried to make it as simple as possible, so you don't get backed up.
You're right.
And I'm trying to relax things a little bit, to speed things up a little bit. So,
Okay. Yeah?
So we get out of that fine dining mentality and sort of, you know, push it forward
turn over.
A little bit.
Okay.
You'll be surprised over a year how many tables you turn quicker.
Which we do. We need to turn them.
The staff quickly preps the mashed potatoes in an attempt to get back on track and push entrees out.
Potatoes.
Service, please.
As Chris finds his groove, the kitchen catches up. And now, for the first time, this dining room is turning tables.
She's gonna sit you down, and we do have a couple of tables getting up in here. And I promise, as soon as we get them cleared, we'll get you right down.
And three more salmon and crabs up, a macaroni.
We used to have nights where we would do 30 dinners, and it felt like 85.
Everything's looking good, guys.
Beautiful.
It's the relaunch, we did 85, it felt like doing 30. It was a nice change, I gotta say.
All right, pick up, please.
It's just gonna take Chris a little while. He's not really good with change. I mean, think about it. We've had the same food on the menu for almost 4 years now, so change is not a thing for Chris.
Are we starting to play down or?
Yeah.
With two dinner seatings completed, the new Hannah and Mason's has successfully cleared its first major hurdle.
The buzz was phenomenal. The vibrance, the freshness, and the feedback was great. However, more importantly to this restaurant is quality control. Her special is to enlighten a customer to what the chef's about.
Fair enough.
You can make mash. Four potatoes peeled, bang. That's where we discipline ourselves.
Yeah, you're right. You're right, I'm saying you're right. Relax, guys, you're right.
Brian, I want you and him to be better. Do you understand? I want you up there and not treading water down there.
I look forward to the future. I still think there's a lot that we need to work out, Chris and I. So, you know, there's still some more changing to do. And this is a start, so we're excited.
I came here because you asked me to come here, yeah, to put this restaurant back on the map. Yeah, the minute I've gone, yeah, it's up to you guys. But one thing you have to do is make money to survive. That means commitment, heart, desire, and the real hunger to make it work. I give you a new menu, new decor, new equipment, new launch. What I cannot give you is the heart to make this successful. That can only come within. And that's what it's gonna take to get this place
pumping.
I think Brian sees that he could put his stamp on this place now as well. I think in the past he thought it was only Chris's place, Chris putting his stamp on. I think he sees now it's a clean slate and he could put his thumbprint on it.
Call me, yes?
I will.
Yeah?
Murray has your cell, right?
She has my email, she has my cell, yeah, and she has my home address. One thing she hasn't got is my fucking hotel room key. Okay. Right, good night. Yes? On, oh!
Thanks,
yes.
Jeff.
Thank you.
Take care.
That was tough. Honestly, really tough. From the minute we had the Valentine's Day massacre to a successful relaunch tonight, it's been a tough week. And I personally feel that I've been dragging Nick, Brian and Chris every inch of the way. And I don't know if they've got the desire to go that extra mile. But what I do know is these apples are delicious.
Stamford, Connecticut is a city that has a vast variety of restaurants. Smack in the center of town is Sabatello's, an Italian eatery opened 3 years ago by its owner, Sammy Settembre. Known for his once successful pizzeria, Sammy has been struggling with this venture and is only months from closing.
How we doing, guys?
I was 8 years old when I started. I worked at my brother Benny's restaurant, starting at making pizza. I always had a dream of a really nice restaurant.
Hey, how are you? How you doing, man?
I make everybody feel like a superstar when they come to Sabatello's because I'm a superstar, and that's why my name is on there. It's all about me.
How are you tonight? Good, thank you. You're welcome.
I've been with Sammy for 2.5 years, and the restaurant was really busy all the time, and it slowly declined.
And we need some customers.
I know, I can't believe this. Usually we have a couple tables. We have an awesome, beautiful place. I think the decor is excellent. I don't know why people are not eating here. The food is good. It fucking kills me. Where is this guy? It was hard as a rock. And it tastes disgusting. If you think of something else to complain about, please get me. I'll be downstairs.
The Neimer at Sabatello's, it's Sammy. He can be really nasty.
Tell him to fucking go to work. If not, go to fuck home.
Hear me? Calamari, to be honest with you, it was edible. That was about it.
Thank God you have a microphone with you. I don't want everybody to hear it.
I think that if Sammy doesn't change, I don't think it would make it another year.
Bye. Fuck out of here. Damn, 8 meatballs in here. Why have we put so many meatballs? Was he a friend of yours? Man, you guys go bowling together? My restaurant's a nightmare because my staff doesn't listen to me all the time. Why you gotta be a big shot with my money, bro? Be a big shot on your day off. Thanks, pal.
Let us talk.
I presently have over $1 million in debt to this restaurant. I have a house on the line, and I cleaned out my savings. Everything rides on this place. 25 or 125?
125.
You sure?
Sammy is very stressed out. When I look at him, knowing him for so many years, I can see a different person. He's just not as happy as he used to be.
I should have been a fucking mailman, swear to God. I waited my whole life to step up to this plate, which is this really nice restaurant, you know, and if I lose this restaurant, I'll lose my life because my restaurant is my life.
As Gordon walks through Stamford, he catches up on Sabatello's most recent food reviews.
Right, food review, Sabatello's. Food mediocre, don't get robbed. The owner is the most obnoxious human being I've ever dealt with. 2-star food at 4-star prices. Here we are. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, well indeed, thank you.
Let me get you a table?
Maybe go upstairs and have a bite to eat.
Yeah, I'll show you. Yes, upstairs. Let me get a menu. I wasn't really nervous when Chef Ramsay came to the restaurant because I make the best Italian food in the world. I'm awesome, and it speaks for itself.
Well, I can't wait to look around. My God, look at this.
Isn't that inviting, nice and warm?
It is nice and warm. So if the decor's nice and warm, the host is nice and warm, it must be all about the food, right?
My food is good. My food is very good.
So what would you recommend for lunch?
My lasagna is homemade.
All this is fresh, right?
Yes, everything else is fresh. If it's not fresh, we don't sell it.
The soup of the day is a?
It's a wedding soup. It consists of vegetables and little mini meatballs. It's really nice. Actually, I have the best balls in town. It's awesome. People love it.
Okay.
When Chef Ramsay sat down, the first thing I thought, man, this guy's gonna be surprised. He's definitely gonna do some kind of cartwheels after he eats his food. So... He's got a few items he wants.
So we start off with the soup of the day. I'm gonna try the lasagna. That's homemade. Mm-hmm. And then finally, I'll finish up with a New York strip.
How do you want that cooked?
Mid-rare.
Steak rare, excuse me, please.
And how long have you been here, David?
3 years.
3 years, wow.
Did you put his order? Okay. Did you put his order in so he
can... I'm talking to him.
I just wanna make sure you take care of him.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, so why does he interrupt you like that?
Sometimes in the middle, I'm giving like specials. Oh, I'm sorry, I gotta bring Dave in. I'm like,
damn.
I'm talking to the people. They feel like, what's the matter with him?
God, that's not nice. That's not nice at all.
Sammy, he got no manners, and I think somebody gotta teach him how he gotta be when he's working.
Give me first the lasagna, and then you're gonna give me the sirloin steak.
You hear what he said? Make it nice, please. You got that wedding soup, right?
Yes.
Well, that was quick.
We got the soup.
Lovely. Mm-hmm. Mm. It's hideous. Like a mishmash of bits of shit put together and brought to the boil, and anemic grey meatballs in there. Mm.
How was your soup?
Yeah. That's the wedding soup?
That's to get him in the mood to get married.
Jesus, I'd rather get fucking divorced.
Oh, my God.
And that's made fresh every day, is it?
Normally, our soups last 2 days.
2 days. How could it be soup of the day when it's soup of yesterday? And it's sort of, it's bland. Anyway, hopefully.
Hopefully the other dishes will be better. Thank you.
Soup of the day.
You said the soup is bland, it's not good? That soup was 2 days old, but that doesn't mean it's garbage. You know what I'm saying? What is he, a fucking health department critic? Oh, my God.
Chef, he says the soup is not good. Well, I can't throw the soups out. That's the rules.
What I want you to do is take 2 lasagnas out, put them in the mic. Make sure the lasagna's nice and hot, Manny. I told him it's my homemade lasagna, my signature item, okay? Do the right thing.
Lasagna, please.
Manny, got dish one?
Wow.
Here's your lasagna.
Homemade lasagna. Oh, Jesus. Look at that. Someone drop it. Jesus. Here we've got like white bits of chicken or veal, but there seems to be something slightly synthetic and plastic inside that tastes absolutely hideous. And if that is homemade, I'll fucking dance in this restaurant tonight, start bollock naked. If that is not homemade, holy crap.
With a steak.
Thank you. What is that in there?
That's the ground beef.
That's beef. It looks like canned dog food. Ask the chef where the recipe's from, if it's homemade.
Don't the recipe de la lasagna.
Which one?
He wants to know if it's a homemade lasagna, where you get the recipe?
My mother.
And where you put ground beef and what was the...
Because it's Italian lasagna. It's not a goddamn Chinese lasagna.
Jesus. It's a tough steak, not seasoned, greasy. The food is consistent. Consistently poor. What a shame. Okay, I'm done. That's full of grease. Where do the steaks come from? Who buys them? Is that Sammy?
Yep.
The food is really, really bad in all aspects.
We've been trying to tell this Sammy for a long time, but of course, because we are the employees, they don't listen.
Having had a good taste of some bad dishes, Gordon heads to the kitchen to meet with Sammy and head chef Jose.
Hi, guys.
How you doing?
Let's go through it together, shall we? Yeah? Soup was hideous. How old is that soup?
The soup has been like 3 days with me, yeah.
3 days with you? Yeah. It tasted like it. It tasted disgusting, bland, and everything was cooked to fuck. The lasagna, let's quickly go on to that. That was unique. Uniquely shit. That's homemade. Where is it?
Tom, where is it?
Lasagna is over there.
Yeah. Can you get me a portion?
Why was it dry in the middle? Was it sauce? Sean, we proportion it, we cut them.
That's it's frozen.
He says it's frozen.
How old is that?
That's the lasagna I make the last week of Friday.
We make 3 trays of lasagna at a time, and then we proportion them, and then we freeze them. We take some up as we need them.
Okay, so it's not fresh. That's what I'm trying to say.
But doesn't mean it's bad. Does it mean it's bad? I'm Italian, man. Here's a guy from Scotland. What the fuck's he know about lasagna? Does any chef throw food away if it's not bad? Answer that, Mr. Ramsay.
Any chef?
Yes.
Yeah.
Hello? You're going to throw it away?
Should I answer it, or are you going to fucking...
No, fucking tell me. Go ahead, fucking tell me.
Are you getting upset now?
No, not at all. Not at all. A little bit, maybe.
Every fucking chef I know makes lasagna fresh every day.
When Chef Ramsay started critiquing, telling me all these bad things about my food, I felt like, what is this guy out of his mind?
Then the biggest disappointment was the steak. Who buys the steak? That's the toughest steak I've ever eaten.
I dropped down on the steaks because my business has dropped. It was a choice steak. It's not my Black Angus, you're right.
I love the way he got excuses for everything.
I couldn't do anything right. I mean, he was amazing. It was very hard for me to swallow. I couldn't believe it. He said everything I did was wrong.
You're very pumped up.
Have you ever thought? Because I believe we have good stuff.
Yeah. Are you asking me or telling me?
I'm telling you. I think maybe you walk up on the wrong side of the bed.
I get out the same side of the bed every day. I know what the fuck I'm talking about, and that food was bland.
I can't believe you're telling me my food sucks. I can't believe it. I honestly think you're out of your fucking mind. It ain't. There's nothing wrong with it.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong. I think you're a little too critical, overcritical.
The minute you get down off your high horse and start understanding what the fuck's wrong with this place, then we may have something compatible to work with.
Are you finished? Are you done?
Am I done?
I can't believe it.
I've just started.
Unbelievable.
Okay, I'm gonna clear my head. I wanted I need some fresh air.
Yeah, want me to show you where the door is?
I'll go through that one there. Thanks.
He critiqued the shit out of me and just like really broke my balls. And this guy's out of control. Yeah, I think someone needs to put him in line. Let me tell you something, man. For a guy to talk like that in front of me like that, I can't believe it. And he's still alive and we didn't shoot him? Fucking kill that guy?
After a night filled with Sammy's excuses, Gordon decides to take a closer look at the kitchen.
Right. This place is spotless. Absolutely spotless. Amazing.
What the fuck? Raw chicken and cooked chicken.
Where's Sammy? What the fuck's that? What is that?
It's called chicken novella.
When were they cooked?
Sunday we do those chickens.
Can you get me Sammy, please? Yeah? Fucking hell. Same shit, different town. Sammy, having a quick look around the kitchen. The place is spotless, yeah? Very clean. Kitchen's immaculate.
We try.
Unfortunately, the shit I found in the fridge. What's this? Have a look at this. That's not the way we cook, is it? What have we got? Chicken franchise there.
Yeah.
Cooked. Sat there. Yeah?
What's the matter with it?
What's the matter with it? What's that set next to?
That's grilled chicken marinade. We do it for sandwiches and for salads.
That's raw chicken, Sammy.
We can't put them close by each other?
Oh, come on. I know you want to mouth off and tell me how fucking wrong I am and I'm a fucking meatballer, but that's appalling. What's this here? It gets worse. What the fuck is that? And why is it cooked?
Because we have to make it raw and bake it in the oven, so it'll take too long. The customers are not going to wait. They're going to leave.
Well, customers aren't here, so how can they leave if they're not here to begin with?
It's a nice dish. People like it.
It's shit.
No, it comes in like his shit doesn't stink, and I was trying to be prepared, but it gets my blood rolling, and he's out of fucking control.
Can you do me a favor? Can you get rid of the cooked meat and put them with cooked meat and the raw meat with raw meat before he fucking kills someone?
He's right.
I'll get back. I'm dying. Holy crap.
Yo, you know that, bro. Jose, you're killing me. My kitchen staff, they're not doing their job. Everybody wants to do something their own way. And there's only one chief, and that's me. Oh, my God.
Four for dinner?
Yes, please.
Main course, I got a stuffed filet of sole, stuffed with a crab meat.
The New York strip.
Yep.
Dinner service tonight is going to be outstanding. And I want to show Chef Ramsay that we really do know how to make good stuff. Jose, I'm waiting for table three. Is that sole almost ready? Thank God.
What's the sole stuff with, Jose?
Do vegetables and imitation crab meat.
Imitation crab meat?
Yeah.
Why imitation?
Crab meat's too expensive. I like fresh stuff in the house. Well, Sammy don't let me do it. And everybody got to follow what he says.
How can we have a special on the sole stuff with fake crab meat?
No, it's not all fake. Jose, you told me the crab meat's fake?
Station crab meat.
I can't wait what kind of bullshit you're going to come back with now.
No, not bullshit at all. Normally, we do put the lump crab meat. We do.
$28. You taking the fucking piss out of Semper?
We all make mistakes. You know, maybe I cut some corners. But don't call me a liar or a cheat or a dishonest guy. I wouldn't be this far being a liar, cheat, and dishonest. So I think you should fucking take it back. Hey. You're making me look horrible in front of this guy. You're my number one guy, right? Son of a bitch.
I don't want the fish. That's not good. Okay. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Okay.
What's the matter with this?
You say it's not fresh. You say it's not good.
Well, it's fucking watery. Oh, no, it's not bad. Not bad. Not bad, though. It's not bad. Not bad. Oh, no, come on. He spits it out. It's not bad.
You're fucking delusional.
No, no, it's not. It's not.
It's mushing, it's watery,
it's not the right gravity, right.
And it's fucking disgusting. You'll jump him down like a big fucking baboon and go, oh, it's good.
Woo! I think we make great food. If I didn't make great food, I wouldn't be here. So for this asshole to fucking tell me that I'm not doing good, it really pissed me off, to be honest with you.
Watching this restaurant perform is embarrassing. Fake fucking crab meat inside a stole. It's pretty obvious that it's become the appendix of restaurants in Stamford. You just want to get rid of it and get it out. Bollocks.
Oh, sorry.
I think I'd like to have it just a little bit more done.
A little more?
Yeah.
Okay. Give me one second.
What's the matter?
Listen, Jose.
What's the matter?
Cook a little more, a little bit.
What's wrong, honey?
Cold in the middle.
All right, put it in the microwave. Just put it in the microwave. Put it in a minute and a half.
Come in the rack and lamb?
The rack and lamb right now.
Cook perfect or you need more?
I kind of got the idea that maybe someone just took this plate because the plate's pretty warm and maybe just stuck back into a microwave instead of putting the lamb chops back into a pan.
You need more?
Yes, thank you.
What's the matter with it now? Yo, what's the matter with it now?
He said if you don't want it.
Fucking busting my balls. Now wait, let me see. Now it's too much cooked for it. It's too fucking rare. And now it's too much? How do they want the meat the first time?
Oh my God.
How do they want it cooked?
Sammy, I don't know.
I'm gonna go fucking ask the lady right now.
With food now coming back, it's a perfect opportunity for Gordon to witness Sammy's customer service skills.
How did you want your meat cooked? Would you want it rare? How do you want it?
Medium rare.
So can we make you another one? Will you wait, or you don't want it at all?
Wait, but the thing is I don't want you to stick it back in a microwave. If it's not.
No, we're gonna throw that out and make you a new one. Nobody's talking about microwave. You're the one who's talking about microwave.
They came out of a microwave. Otherwise, they wouldn't be like exuding heat.
Do you work for a microwave company? You know so much about a microwave. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Fuck out of here. Tell her to take a hike.
That is rude.
Fuck that lady.
Taste it, Sammy.
Bullshit. Told me you went to a microwave? I'm gonna make it. Let her wait. Let her wait now. I don't know if this lady wanted a free meal or whatever. I thought it was a total nightmare. I kept my composure. I wanted to kill her, and I didn't.
Jose, it's not your fault. The lamb is tough. If you've even shit tools to work with, of course you're gonna create shit food. Here's the lamb market.
Bring it to her. Come on, I'm gonna follow you. No, wait, we're not done yet. I wanna see you cut into it. How is it? Is it still too rare?
You know what? I'm done. No more chances.
Unbelievable. Oh my God, I just wanted to pick her up and throw her out. There's a right way and a wrong way of handling something like that, and she was totally wrong. She sends it back three fucking times, asking, how does she want to cook?
Go out there and apologize to them.
I don't want to apologize.
Sammy.
I don't give a fuck. Let it go. Sick of it.
Go out and apologize to them.
I'm actually really embarrassed that he made a scene with one of the customers tonight. Regardless of what happened, the customer is always right in a customer service business.
So fucking mad. It sucks. I'm like so upset inside. I'm fucking fumigating. Tonight I look like a jerk off for this asshole. The real job tonight. You know something? Don't even make it none. Shut everything fucking down and forget it. I don't really give a fuck. Shut it down. Don't fucking do nothing. So fucking mad. Tonight I look like a jerk off for this asshole.
After a frustrating evening in the kitchen and in the front of house, Sammy has hit his breaking point.
You know something? Don't even fucking make it none. Shut everything fucking down and forget it. I don't really give a fuck. Shut it down. Don't fucking do nothing. It was one of the worst nights of my life. And I wanted to strangle the customers tonight. I wanted to strangle my guys, especially in the kitchen, everybody. It was just a total nightmare. It was a mess.
Ladies, thank you very much. Thank you, guys. I'm sorry.
That's all right, it's not your fault.
Thank you for being so understanding. Oh, I really appreciate it.
I'm the person that apologizes for Sammy because he won't do it. And I don't want his reputation to be any worse than I guess people already see it.
I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
All the time he does the same story, all the time the same problem. Sammy, he don't care.
I fucking lost it. I feel so mad, I feel so hurt. I can't get my staff to listen. I feel like running away, tell you the truth.
After an unusual evening in which Sammy shut down his own restaurant, Gordon has now confirmed the source of the problems at Sabatello's.
58 customers we serve. Not 108, 58. I've never seen 58 covers done in such a difficult way, you know that. Is that normal for you to go into the kitchen like that and talk to them like that?
If I didn't go in there at all, forget about it. We wouldn't have 20 entrees come back.
You've got no right, as an owner, to be so selfish and start picking on fucking staff or blaming customers. The problem is with you.
Come on, are you serious?
You agitate customers, you agitate staff. Why are you so negative?
What do you mean negative? I try to keep these guys happy. I was in there trying
That's
to...
That's happy?
Are you kidding me? Guys are making mistakes like
that. No, you gotta go back to school.
He said that all this is about me. The way the place is going wrong. Nobody talks to me like that. People come here because of me. People love my food.
Sammy, I'm here to help. I see a guy that's passionate about running a restaurant, but fucking clueless. You're the hardest individual to work with, my friend. And each and every one of your staff are shit scared to tell you that. You handicap the kitchen, a menu far too big with two cooks in there, and you've got such fucking imitation material on here, they can't cook it.
What do you mean imitation material?
That steak's not fucking Black Angus, 1855.
We used to carry Black Angus.
It's what you're charging for now, Sammy. It's not about you used to. $28 for a stuffed, rolled fucking fillet of sole with fake crab. Hey, you're a bullshitter.
Yeah, I made some mistakes. I cut a couple corners. Why? I'm in a fucking tough spot right now. What the fuck? He would do it too, no?
Look at the level of false advertising on your menu and stop taking the piss out of you and Stanford.
Did you forget anything? That's it? So all this is about me?
Of course it is. I've got to rethink. I've got some fucking ideas and some plans. I've got to get going quickly. But I want you to do one thing.
And what's that?
Take your head out your arsehole and get fucking real with me.
Okay.
I'll see you in the morning. Good night. Stubborn fucker.
I don't need this jerk off to fucking tell me about how I run my business. Don't tell me that all this is because of me. He's full of fucking shit. I didn't like that. And next time that I see him in person, I'm gonna fucking tell him.
It's a new day, and Gordon has come up with a plan to get Sammy back on track.
Yeah, how are you?
Good.
Yeah, good. Sit down. You look pissed like you're ready for a fight. Do you think I'm here to fight?
No, I don't. I think you have good intentions.
You're a tough guy to get through to.
I know, I know.
You've got this defense mechanism that no one seems to break down. I came in early this morning to sort of talk to you, to sort of try to get through. So I want you to take me back to the beginning. I need to know more about Sammy 10 years ago. You ready?
Yes.
Holy mackerel.
How did you get this picture? Because I had these under lock and key.
That's a bit I like at the bottom. Owning my own business, succeeding by 35.
I always loved the restaurant business, working for my brother since I was small, 9 years old, making dough to making sandwiches and eventually making pizza.
Which brings me into this.
Oh my God. My brother Benny passed away 7 years ago. Actually, get me all choked up here.
This man's a hero in your life, right?
He's the one that really got me motivated. I love him. He was like more of a father. I mean, I would do anything for him. He was awesome.
Do you miss him?
Totally. Because it's like now, I would love to call him and ask for some advice. It's like I don't know where to turn. It all has to come from me. I'm like I'm bombarded everywhere. Yeah. I can't believe you got that picture.
There you go. This was a huge success, this thing.
That's how I made my money. That's how I bought my house in Greenwich. That's how I got this. Now I feel like everything is draining me. I'm trying to keep this afloat, and it's not a little place anymore. Over there was smaller overhead, I had less people, maybe I had more control over it. Now it's like, I don't know.
Look at that. You remember that day like it was yesterday, right?
Yes.
Look, restaurateur gives students a taste of a career in the kitchen.
He loves it.
That's you in, you know, mentoring, tutoring, prolific position. Now look at the way you were dealing with your staff and your customers last night, and, you know, it's fucking night and day. And that's where I need to connect, in there. That Sammy. Not today, Sammy. I need your support, but more importantly, I need to get you back in love with the restaurants.
Okay. Listen, you got my word. Not 110%, I'm gonna give you 220%. I want that same feeling back. I wanna be that same Sam. It's sad that I wait this long.
Thank you.
Please. Thank you for your help. Thank you.
Not at all.
Chef Ramsay, and what he did really opened up my eyes. I feel like something's brewing. Something's going, something's moving. It's the best thing I haven't felt in a long time, to be honest with you.
Now that Sammy is focused once again, Gordon has begun to make some menu changes for tonight's dinner service.
Straightforward lasagna. First off, a small amount of bolognese sauce. Two nice layers. A little bit of mozzarella in the middle. Heavy ricotta on top. Nothing gets put in the freezer. In the oven now. Okay. So we'll do a grilled filet mignon. Table side. A little bit of thyme on there. And we're going to roast it now in the oven. She goes. Some potatoes. And Brussels sprouts.
Now that Gordon has shown them how to prepare tonight's specials, he is looking for the front of the house to create some excitement in the dining room.
Here we go. Two nice slices, not thin slices. Up, lift, bang, and away. And present. Great. This is just one small measure of you personally reaching out and doing something different here.
Sabatelles has never done tableside, so we're excited about it. Actually, I'm very excited. I got my confidence back. I got my balls back. I got my lasagna back on track. It's gonna be great tonight.
With news that Gordon Ramsay is in town, Sabatello's is busier than it has been in years. But only time will tell if we'll see the volatile Sammy or the personable, friendly Sammy.
I'm gonna totally have an awesome night tonight. When people walk out tonight, they're gonna be thinking, wow, is that Sammy? What a difference.
We got two specials for tonight. We got a nice baked lasagna. Also, I got a nice black Angus filet mignon. You don't even need a steak knife, by the way. I tried the filet mignon, okay?
Okay, take your time.
I'm very excited for tonight. I feel comfortable to go to the tables and sell the food.
We're gonna get, the filet.
Thank you.
How we doing, Jose? Can you do that 13, table 13? And what about 15? You got one for 15, which is three?
This man has to talk. He doesn't open up.
I know. He always.
In 1 hour's time, we're gonna be fucked.
Look, Jose, come on, man. Help me out.
Don't rush me to get the table out. When you rush, nothing is good.
Thank you, bro. All right, up the stairs, please. Be careful.
Is this medium? Actually, you know what? That's really rare.
Want me to cook a little more?
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
I'm sorry.
No problem. Just give me a few minutes, all right?
Oh no.
The medium, not medium rare.
Oh, come on. For fuck's sake.
This is supposed to be medium, bro. Come on.
Don't let me down, Jose. Come on, quick.
He's, like, completely behind already.
Hi. My husband's steak is raw inside.
You want me to cook more?
It's total.
Yeah. Take a minute. Okay. You're welcome.
Want a little cook a little
more? That's medium. I asked for medium.
Put this back in the room, medium.
Medium.
No. What happened?
Who wants a medium next steak?
What's it say on the ticket?
It said medium. Just read the ticket, pal. It's very simple.
Although dinner service started out with a very cool, calm Sammy, problems in the kitchen have brought out the old Sammy.
God damn it!
He's doing the middle light. He's serving it out.
I'm tired of fucking excuses. I'm taking all the blame here. I look like a fucking jerk off. This whole fucking town, I'm tired of it. Jose is not communicating, trying to do everything himself, in turn slowing the restaurant down and making me look bad and making me go under. I am not gonna let that happen. Jose, just make the food, damn it.
Unfucking believable.
Jose, just make the food, damn it.
Although Sammy may have been the main cause of the problems last night.
You don't lose, I lose. I lose everything here.
Tonight, head chef Jose and the kitchen staff have dug a hole for the restaurant that is virtually impossible to get out of.
You guys are not communicating. I told you, he's so thankful, John. You see what ticket? Ask him, what are you working on? Yes, sir. No, call me. Let me know that you hear me. Yes, Sammy, I got it. I don't know you're listening. It was just a total nightmare. It was a mess. It was a real mess. Nobody had their act together. Nobody knew what they were doing. We kept getting in the weeds. We kept getting behind.
Yes, supposedly.
Out in the dining room, the customers continue to feel the effects of the problems in the kitchen.
You want me to cook a little more?
A little bit more will be good.
Sure. For you, it's fine.
I know you said you had a hard time doing...
I'm meek. Yeah, don't worry.
Thanks.
No problem. What's wrong? Say medium.
Fucking hell. Hey, now, listen, you've got to listen to me now. It's not good enough, Jose. Medium requested.
No more excuses. Come on. We gotta communicate better. Otherwise, I'm gonna lose my fucking shirt. Everything I ever fucking worked for is being shot down the tube and being a laughing stock of fucking Stanford. Who the fuck wants that?
We've been here for hours.
hours. I'm hungry.
Lass, are you hungry?
Yeah, we're hungry.
Jose, let him do the vegetables. Damn it. Manu, don't let Jose do all the work, because he's too goddamn slow. We're losing everything here. He speaks Spanish, talking in Spanish. I don't care. Yo, can we do 61?
I can't. It's not cooked as
a
meal.
Do 63. Why don't we finish the tickets you have in the fucking front of you? Don't even grab these tickets. Do 63. Get it going.
It's going already?
No,
it's coming
now. We need it now. You got it going?
It's coming now.
Yeah, we need it now. Jose, we can't keep these people fucking waiting. You're better than that, Jose. God.
Cold dinner.
Very cold.
It was a disaster. This is one of the worst nights I've ever had. Yeah, sit down.
Another night, another rough service, and Sabatello's is clearly running out of time.
The big issue here is the kitchen. You have had a relationship with that guy for 13 or 14 years. It's like a married couple, yeah? You've switched off from each other. You bark, he ignores.
I'm not happy with him. You know something? I have been too lazy letting him do everything and not checking up on him. I'm really starting to open up my eyes. I can't count on this fucking guy anymore. What are the fucking truth? I can't count on him. And tonight, I thought it was gonna be so easy with steaks. You sent a meaty out of the fucking rare. Everything came back rare. Any asshole can cook steaks.
I'm glad you say it.
I gotta do something different.
You're absolutely right.
And the more comfortable I get with this jerk off, the more they take advantage of me. But I'll be honest with you, he doesn't step up to the plate tomorrow, let him go get somebody to place it. It breaks my heart. What all the fucking truth? I'm tired of it. That's what pisses me off.
That is exactly what I wanted to hear in the middle of service.
I'm not going to count on Jose doing the job anymore and just sit back and let this guy do what he want. Ain't happening. It's either I make changes now or I fail. I don't want to fail.
After witnessing two failed dinner services, Gordon spent the night devising a plan to alleviate the problems in the kitchen.
Let's discuss menu. Okay, there we are.
Well,
now, the secret behind this is we're going to streamline the menu. We've increased the meat. We've brought down the appetizers, the greens, the sides, desserts. Look at the size of the menu, Jose. That is done to the maximum ability of what we've got to cook out of from downstairs.
This new menu is going to be more better for us to knock all the food out. It's going to be easy for me.
Tomorrow, we're going to relaunch this restaurant as a unique Italian steakhouse. Sammy, what do you think?
I'm blown away by it. What an awesome menu. It's so much nicer. It's smaller. It's more attractive. Got some really nice entrees there. Really awesome. Change it to an Italian steakhouse totally made a lot of sense because I have too much competition. I think now we have something to show people.
We're oozing quality, freshness, great steaks, great wine. Happy?
I'm excited. Yeah.
Lauren?
Excited.
Excited.
Yeah. Okay, good.
I was very nervous, had a lot of doubts, but after seeing the menu, I'm not so nervous anymore. I feel more confident and so prepared now to do something different.
Let's go.
With the relaunch dinner just hours away, Gordon meets Sammy and the staff to introduce the new dishes on the menu.
Okay, entrees. This is our selling point. The bistecca, we've seen that. It flew out the kitchen. Okay, 14-ounce bone-in New York steak. Look at it. 6-ounce filet mignon grilled lobster tail. That, for me, is the heartbeat of this restaurant. If we can establish that kind of excitement with our Italian steakhouse, everything else will follow suit. That's our jewel. Dig in, have a taste, get familiar with it, and push it.
Unbelievable, right? Try it. Chef Ramsay's menu compared to my menu is totally different. Mine was old school.
Look at the way it's perfectly cooked.
Chef Ramsay's menu is so innovative, so different, so new. I like it, and I should have changed it a long time ago. Can I tell you right now? I want you, everybody, to make that food like that. If not, it's not acceptable. See where it's over there?
Yeah.
I want it to be the same all the time.
Yeah.
All right? And the appetizer, I want it to be the same. I told Manny, too. And yeah. I'm telling you. Because you know something, man? I can't be nervous anymore. Worried if I'm going to keep this place, I'm not going to keep it, if I'm going to lose it. You hear me?
All right, that's enough.
This week, with this guy, unbelievable, man. Really opened up my eyes.
Yeah.
Not to just do the same fucking thing over and over, and look what we got. Nobody give me fresh ideas. Nobody helping me out. Listen what this guy did. Thank God this guy came. God bless this guy. You know that? It's my fault. You know that? Sitting on my ass, not trying to make a change.
Yeah.
Good. Tonight, I'm counting on Jose. The kitchen has to function better. Has to happen in the kitchen. I want it to work.
With a brand new menu and a community willing to give Sabatello's another shot.
Hi, how are you?
Good.
It's got some awesome specials tonight. Homemade lasagna.
It's now up to Sammy to show what he's made of.
Okay, and also the filet mignon is really good. I am so excited about tonight. Actually, I'm nervous and excited, but it's a good nervous. It's like having little butterflies before you go on stage.
What I recommend from the grill is the bistecca. It's delicious.
With the restaurant now focused on being an Italian steakhouse, Jose's ability to cook meat is put to the test.
Come on, Jose. We're grilling steaks and we're cooking to order, yes? Show me it can be done, yeah? Big night. Got to talk.
I got it. Coming up.
We're going to split the bistecca.
How do you like
it? Medium well is good.
Okay.
Big night tonight. It's relaunch night and a couple of questions unanswered. Can Sammy run the restaurant the way it should be run? And can Jose deliver on a menu that can possibly save this restaurant? Right now, I don't know.
Welcome to Sabatello's. This is so good, it's like M&M's gonna melt right in your mouth.
Wow, thank you.
Enjoy, sir. Guys, enjoy. I told the guys, this is our last hurrah. If we don't do it tonight, I'm gonna lose everything that I work hard for, my family, responsibility to the community, everything.
All right, I like the 6 ounce filet.
Portobello polenta.
Polenta?
Yes.
Sure.
How's that?
Good.
As orders pile in,
you gotta start setting some tables out, or else we're gonna be in the weeds.
The kitchen is about to be put to the test, and so is Sammy's patience.
It's a lot of pasta. Make me another one.
We need to get this kitchen up and running and get the food to the table a lot quicker.
You make the enchilada Mediterranean?
Not ready yet.
Can you make that spaghetti butter back?
No, it's not ready.
Can you fire it right away? You hear me, pal?
I hear you, sir.
I feel like I'm babysitting. I hate fucking babysitting. I gotta babysit the staff. I gotta babysit the kitchen.
It's more like
red.
Red.
Oh, come on. You've got to listen to me now. It's stone cold.
I don't know why.
I'm getting really nervous.
I want to keep the customer happy, please. Used to be good cooking. Used to be fast as hell. I don't know what happened. Getting old? And Jose's not doing the work. We kept getting in the weeds. We kept getting behind.
Come with me. Here's my worry. 58 covers in, second turn of service, table's coming through, yes?
Yes.
Service too slow. But this is not normal. This is fucking worse than Spaghetti House. Okay. Is that what you're doing?
No.
Come on, fucking hell.
I think Jose's kind of lost his sense of drive, you know, I guess me being too hard on him. I finally realized that we need to help him out.
Show me it can be done, yeah?
With everything at stake, Sammy decides to jump behind the line to help Jose. But will he make it better or worse?
Let's do it. Put it in. That's good, bye-bye. No, I'll do it, I'm gonna do everything myself. Just give me the equipment team. When I'm over there, I need you, not now. Fuck, should've did this a long time ago. $1,200 in my pocket. It's all good. Here, let's read the thing. Oh my God, Jose, kill me. Son of a fucking bitch. Watch out, Todd. Oh, fuck me.
It's relaunch night. And knowing it's do or die for Sabatello's, Sammy has jumped behind the line to help.
Oh, my God. Son of a fucking bitch. Thanks, tell me it's hot, cocksucker. Thank God that my kitchen guys are not involved in any bombs or rockets or decisions because we all be in danger. Put the meat back up or you can't take it all. You're not fucking Superman. Come on. Waste of time. Put it. Jose, get it done. All right, you're killing me, damn it. I just want to get through tonight. I fucking had it. I got it. Do another ticket. Let me do it. I'm gonna do everything myself.
How much longer would we have to wait?
I'll double check on the time, but I would give it about 25 or 30 minutes. You're still waiting for that table at the bar.
What's that?
They got the filet mignon.
How can we forget about that table? Yeah. The machine printed it out down here exactly 2 minutes after you were in the kitchen.
Which one you got? I gave you two medium rare, bro.
You're the right one, bro. They're confused now.
Talk to him in Spanish. Does he understand what he's saying? I don't think he understands. Talk to him in Chinese. Well, this is all gonna die here. I'm not on that fucking side tonight. So unorganized. We don't know shit.
If they need you back there, you should know what you're doing. It's coming, I promise. They just wanted to make sure it was nice and hot.
It was really frustrating for the six people at the bar, and they were sitting at the bar waiting for their food, and that shouldn't happen.
How far behind is the...
It's coming out right now. Here it comes right now.
After a long wait by many of the customers, Gordon hopes the new dishes will be worth the wait.
Enjoy, guys.
It's really good, though. Really good. Very good.
but this is absolutely delicious. I can't believe the change.
Sabatello's relaunch ended successfully, primarily because when the kitchen struggled early on, Sammy jumped behind the line and helped instead of spinning out of control.
Still shot with these guys. Give me 7 on the fly.
Beautiful.
Hey.
Hey.
To a better day at Sabatello's.
Hey.
All right?
Hey, good luck in the future.
Tonight, making these changes to an Italian steakhouse, it was a step in the right direction. I mean, it was a new menu. It was our first time doing it. There was a few mistakes, but we're moving forward. I think it's gonna only get better and help the restaurant.
I'm leaving here with the Sammy that I've always wanted. Hey, look at me. Seriously, big boy. A man that's back in control. He knows exactly what to do. Move forward and make those changes.
I'm gonna do my very best.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Thank you.
Fucker. Take care.
When I first met Chef Ramsay, I thought he was an arrogant jerk.
Yes, hideous.
And then I kind of saw the way he comes about it. He really does care. And he made me realize I have a purpose. And he got something out of me that I haven't had come out in a long time. And that's hunger, creativity. It's the will of doing good again.
Take care.
My God, finally. I honestly thought I'd have to wait for a lunar eclipse before that guy seriously got the message. And who knows, sometimes miracles can happen.